I go to session two now, exploring our aspirations and concerns. So in the previous session, you were asked to do the following: make a list of your aspirations, expectations of your family and friends, and the hopes you see the nation has from you. Make a list of your achievements in life, make a list of your concerns, fears, confusions, questions. Now, the same thing has been listed by every student for oneself, and then we can make a compiled list here. Okay. Now, when we make that list, then we can go to further investigate into that list. So we are all making tremendous effort, and in the effort that you are making to fulfill your aspiration or to resolve your concerns or confusions or questions or for something else, this is something to be found out. So whether the effort that you are doing today at this moment, is it to fulfill your aspirations or to resolve some concerns or confusions or questions or something else? Now the three things are different. Let's say I have some aspiration. I want to become a doctor or some engineer. Okay, I want to become an engineer. That is one aspiration of mine. Okay. Now the concern could be my father has lost his job during the pandemic, and the family is finding it very difficult to even take care of the household expenses. So that is one concern. Confusion is like whether I should be staying in my hometown and then working so that I can take care of my family, because my father, mother is sick and she needs somebody all the time available with her. Or should I leave the city and go to some other city, go abroad or something? So there could be a confusion, and there could be multiple such confusions. Okay. And then there are some questions. So what would be the best way to get a job of a good package? Let's say a package of 20 lakhs or something. What would be the best way to go abroad? When should I go for preparing for some examination which can take me abroad? So there could be some questions. And there could be something else also. The students may have some problems of adulthood, and those things also could be there and which can be running in their imagination. So make a list of all the effort that you are making today and try to see, okay, the basic motivation or the basic reason behind that. So let me take a reflection from you here. Parikshit Bhaiya, is the effort that you are making, is it to fulfill your aspirations or to resolve your concerns, confusions and questions or something else? So I'll say in retrospect, you go back, try to feel yourself as a teenager entering into a graduation program, take some time and try to think at that stage of life, what were you doing? What was your effort and what was the motivation behind the effort? Was it to fulfill your aspiration or to resolve some concerns, some confusions, some questions or something else? In place of looking at your state today, try to look in retrospect. Try to look few years back when you were a teenager of 16 or 17 years of age and you had entered into that bachelor's program. And then just try to see what was your state of imagination there. And then only, you know, you are able to see the other person, the student sitting in front of you, similar to you. Now, it is generally said that when we are a student or a teenager, we think in one manner, but when you become a parent, it might be something quite contrasting to it, quite different from it. Then you start feeling that these students are not responsible, they are not punctual, they are not taking care of health, they're not doing this, they're not doing that. We have this kind of feeling when we have children of our own. But when we were a child, and just try to think what was our state of imagination, what was our state of mind there, and then try to reflect upon this. In the meantime, I'll take some question. Dr. Mona Lisa. Dr. Pragyan. I hope I'm audible to you. Dr. Shakti Prakash.
Good afternoon, sir.
Ji, good afternoon. You have any questions, sir? You have raised
your hand? No, sir.
Okay, fine, sir. Dr. Sandhya. Okay. Okay, Dr. Gariba. Dr. Garima, you have raised your hand. Dr. Sandhya. Anyway, then let me proceed. So many hands are raised, but I hope I'm able to reach you properly because I'm not getting response. So, yeah. So almost 2/3 of the participants are saying that the effort that they have been making at that stage of life were to fulfill their aspirations. And about 1/3 are saying that it was to resolve some concerns. Nice. Now this is something to be addressed properly, okay, this particular thing. Okay, is it something out of aspirations, their fulfillment, or out of some kind of fear, some kind of confusion? So this is has to be addressed properly. It is generally said, no, that if you look at a human being with a lack of right understanding, there are three general concerns, and that is fear of the future, conflict with the present, and pains of the past. So this is the way in general a human being is operating. So we have to be aware of that. So make a list of all the effort that you are making. Also note down why you are making that effort. What is the basic motivation behind that effort? And what is your basic aspiration? So behind all these aspirations, is there something basic to it? So examples could be like, I'm studying hard so that I get a degree. So that what? I'm studying hard, I'm studying day and night. And I think that after studying hard, I will get a good degree. Now, why do I want to get a good degree? Let's say to get a job. Why do I want to get a job? To get money. Why do I want to get money? There is a kind of practice in management also that says, ask why 5 times. That is also included in some management principles. Ask why 5 times so that you can get back to the basic root, the basic cause, the basic motivation. So try to question things in this manner. Even today, we can look into our own aspirations, our own imagination, and try to find out by asking these questions like, why? I'm working diligently. Why? To earn a respectable living. Why? Now, if you start asking these kinds of questions, then you are able to reach your basic aspiration. Like when you attended the previous workshop, the basic aspiration was proposed to you and you agreed to it. But in your imaginations, has it been sorted out that this is the basic aspiration that you are working for? Or we get caught up in our petty aspirations and start working for them. So if you look at the present effort, now let us look into the scenario that we have with the students. If you look in the present effort, the effort is to become something. Okay, so one is doing something, thinking something. And it is expected that we become something out of that. Now, what could be the possibilities? So let's say somebody is studying day and night, studying very hard, spending 8 hours a day in studying. Somebody is doing internship or doing some practice, attending a coaching, doing articleship, doing MBA, conducting research. Okay, or even somebody is involved in painting. Now, the aspirations out of these could be like to become an engineer, to become a doctor, to become a farmer, to become an IAS officer, to become a lawyer or a chartered accountant, to become a businessman, to become a scientist, to become an artist. These are various expectations. So some effort is being put in, but if you look into the underlying expectation behind those efforts, it is something to become. Now let us look deeper. Is it final thing that I have to become something, or there is something beneath it, there is something which is motivating this. So we'll go further to explore. Now, whatever one wants to become, if you see the expectation behind it, it is to get something or do something. For example, I want to become an engineer. Why? To get money, or it could be to earn name and fame, or it could be to do research or do some innovation, or to take care of my parents. Okay, to make my family or nation proud, to gain expertise in the area of my choice, to earn my living well, to live with self-respect, to get power in society, to earn respect, to get satisfaction, and it could be a long list. Okay, so one has to be clear. So to get money is one thing, to do research is something else. So you'll see that all these things can be clubbed into two broad heads. Either I'm expecting to get something out of my efforts, out of becoming something, or I'm trying to do something. When I'm trying to get something, I'm trying to get something from outside for myself. And when I'm trying to do something, I'm trying to give from my side to the outside world. So our expectations are somewhat revolving around these two things, okay? To get something from outside or to do something. And both can go together. To get money, okay, is one part, and to do research is another part. So to make my family or nation proud is doing something, okay, to make my family and nation proud, right? To gain expertise in the area of my choice is to get something. So in a similar manner, you can question. Now, again, ask yourself, is it ultimate? To get money, to earn name, fame, to do research, is it ultimate or something which is underlying this? I'll say that when we are asking this question to the students, one has to look within oneself also. Why am I doing a job? Okay. Why am I working day and night? Why am I spending 30 and 40 years of my age, okay, of my lifetime into this kind of thing? What is my motivation behind that? So I suggest that when you are going to conduct a session for the students, do this exercise for yourself. Then this will give you a deeper insight into all these issues, into all these words, okay, into the kind of formulation that has been done. Now you'll see that even behind this expectation to get or do something, there is an expectation to be something. Each one of us wants to be something as a human being. What is that expectation to be something? It is to be happy and prosperous. Out of all this, the basic aspiration is to be happy and prosperous. Though we might not be able to relate this basic aspiration in different stages of our effort. When I'm studying something, I'm not very clear whether I want to be happy or not. It's just because everybody is studying. My siblings are studying, my friends are studying. Okay, and somebody has joined the coaching there, somebody has joined the online course there, somebody has joined some kind of internship there. Okay, somebody is going to father's friend's company and trying to spend some time there learning things. So it becomes a kind of peer pressure out of which I also start working. But am I clear that I want to be happy and prosperous? Is happiness clear to me? Is prosperity clear to me? In fact, it's a kind of strange thing that when you talk to the students, not a single student is able to define what is happiness. They have that aspiration of being happy, of being prosperous, but they're not able to define it. They're not very clear about it. And when you try to define, they feel that it is something completely tangent to their imagination. It is not something in which they have invested any time for exploration. Okay, so it just becomes like the goal is somewhere else and we are looking for the solution or the program somewhere else. Okay, not exactly focused on our goal. So what could be the right way? So let me say that I'll take a few questions here and then I'll go ahead. I lower all the hands for once. Are you able to see this kind of formulation? Why it has been placed like this, Professor Nachiketa?
Kumar bhaiya.
Ji.
Actually, earlier also one madam has raised a very important question about that aspirations and expectations. Normally we associate expectation with the kind of thing you are going to get or you are to do something. But as far as this expect to be something comes, there we should put aspiration to be happy and prosperous. Normally aspiration is associated with a higher thing and expectation with a lower dimensions. So I think we should, as far as this use of word is concerned, I think we should put aspire to be something and expect to become something, expect to get or do something. That's okay. And aspire to be something. Because aspirations, as you have understood, is something bigger, something greater, something deeper than expectation. That is what just I want to suggest.
Okay. In fact, a good suggestion here, sir. You can put aspire or expect, because when I aspire for something, I have some clarity about it. But when I just expect something, I might not have any clarity, though I am expecting that this will happen. So one may have a clarity, and then we can add that choice here. Of course, that can be added. Fine, sir. Professor Nachiketa.
Thank you, Kumar Bhaiya. Thank you.
Mrs. Selina? Mrs. Selina? So I think what I'll do, it is 11:30 already, so we'll have a bio break of 15 minutes. Namaste, everybody. So we're talking about this. When the student is making some effort, then the expectation is to become something, and that is essentially focused at getting or doing something, but there's something beneath it, something behind it, and that is to be something. So what to be, that is something that we have to make out, and we'll see that each one of us wants to be happy and prosperous, and that also in continuity. So that is the basic aspiration for each one of us. So when we are doing this kind of exercise, we have to enrich the exploration in such a manner that the students are able to see this basic aspiration for themselves. Now, if you see further, let me take...
Kumar Bhaiya.
Ha, Bhaiya.
Kindly resume share one more time. I mean, stop and stop sharing and share screen one more time.
Is it visible now, Bhaiya?
Ji, Bhaiya.
Ji, Bhaiya. Okay.
So let me take a reflection here. I'm able to relate this discussion to my personal life. Yes, no, cannot say. In the meantime, I can take a few questions. Dr. Balbir Singh, Dr. Ranganath. I hope we have addressed Dr. Ranganath.
Bhaiya, we could not hear Ranganath, sir, because voice was not audible.
Good morning, sir. Is it audible, sir?
Yeah, audible, sir.
Sir, only that one doubt is there. There is in the evening session, that is 6 to 8 is there. And due to some extreme emergency on any particular day, so can we miss and can do the in our own time? Or is it attendance is also there for this 6 to 8
no, PM sir. Session is there, sir? There is no online session during that period. So it is okay. For you to do your home assignment.
Okay, sir. Okay, sir. Yeah. Thank you, sir.
Mr. Ranganath, if you can reach us, then please speak up. Mrs. Shanmuga. Dr. Abhijit. I can see some more hands raised.
Hello, sir. Am I audible?
Yeah, audible, sir.
Sir, basically, I would like to ask one thing. Is that at the age of 22 when we are teaching a student, like how would he imagine for the future? Because what happens, he gets indulged into efforts only, and the second step which you have written here, it's become something, maximum he reaches up to get money.
He
is not able to imagine about family, and so how to make him imagine that ultimately the goal has to be to become happy. This particular goal people do not understand throughout their life also sometimes. Such a difficult task it is actually.
Truly said, sir. In fact, if you look at the induction program, this is one of the major objectives, to give such a broad vision of life in place of being short-sighted in terms of just earning some money, getting a job, okay, getting some degree, getting some name and fame. If the students can have a holistic vision of life, so that would really help. That would help even transform the whole atmosphere inside the campus also. If the faculty also are able to see this in the broad sense, students are also able to see, then there will not be any short-sightedness in their vision. There will not be issues coming up out of those out of the short-sightedness of the students and faculty. There are many issues in the campus, if you see, that is because of this short-sightedness. Yes. The students and the faculty are not able to see that essentially they want to be happy. Why to enter into a conflict, enter into a tussle, okay? Why to enter into a blame game or something? Essentially, each one of us wants to be happy and make other happy.
Yes.
If you are able to see this very clearly, and in fact, the students know, if you look at their stage of life, then they are quite afresh. They have got some conditioning in the schools, but that has not been so deep and vast. If you are able to mend them, if you are able to transform them at this early stage of higher education, it will help a lot.
Yes, sir. Really a great insight. Thank you, sir.
Yeah, nice, sir. Dr. Balbir?
Yes, sir. Hello?
Yes, yes, Dr. Balbir.
Sir, mostly in taking classes, especially in the first class, we used to ask what is their goal, especially for the first year students. So mostly I think some... you can say that some 30 to 40% the students, they are not able to decide what to do and why they are coming here.
Mm-hmm.
And others, that 50 to 60%, they will say like, I want to become an engineer, or I want to be a IAS, or I want to, they have some goals are there, but not the, what are the basic aspirations? That is a very important part is there. So why they want to be there. So of course we are also not digging up to that extent also, what, no, we are also coming into interaction. So that is a good stuff. So thank you very much. This is only I want to share.
Nice, Dr. Balbir. So let me proceed with this. So let me share the results of the reflection. So almost all of you are saying that yes, you are able to relate this to your personal life. So nice. Now, just try to see which one is your basic aspiration at stage 1 or 2 or 3 or 4. Okay, which one is the basic aspiration? Parikshit bhaiya, try to find out. Is it the present effort, or to become something, or to do or get something, or to be something? In the meantime, let me take a few questions. Mrs. Rupali.
Hello, sir.
Hello, ma'am.
Yeah, I wanted to talk about this happiness and, feeling of being prosperous. Mm-hmm. So, when you take admission, for example, when I took admission, it is a kind of self-reflection which I'm going to share with you. Is that fine, sir?
Yeah, fine, ma'am. Briefly, yeah.
Yeah, briefly. So the thing is, you know, being so many, you know, three daughters, my mother always wanted us to, you know, stand on our own feet and earn the thing. So that was my basic thinking. I wanted to be engineer. And that was my aspiration in those days. And I took admission for. But what I mean to say is, I felt that, you know, if I have a respectable life where my intellectual needs are being satisfied and I get a good lifestyle, then I.
Ma'am, you are not audible anymore. Mrs. Rupali, you have lost your connection, I think. We'll wait for a few seconds and then I'll take some other reflection. Okay, maybe ma'am will join sometime. So in the meantime, let me take the reflection of Dr. Kakita. Dr. Kakita.
Good morning, sir.
Yeah.
Good morning. Sir, I have one small doubt. Like, it is written refresher course part one. So there will be part two, as I found, like, it's a 10 days program. So another 5 days will be there. So for that 5 days, do we have to do any more registration, or it's a continuous process? Again, it will be scheduled.
Fresh registrations will be there, sir.
So again, we have to go for finding out when it will be opened. We have to register
it. Yes. Presently, we have not conducted part two so far.
Okay.
Okay. But we are planning to conduct. We want more and more people to go through part one first.
Okay.
And then they will be doing some self-study, going through the book and the notes. And they will also be conducting the mentoring program for the students. And then only they will qualify for part two.
Part two. Okay.
Part two is essentially meant for teaching the course in the second year.
Okay. 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 Okay, thank you, sir. Thank you for that. Thank you.
Nice. Okay, so if I look at the reflection that I have got, let me say that you have to listen to what we are saying here more with more concentration, because most of you have written that the present effort is a basic aspiration. How come? Can I get some feedback on this? To become something is also listed as basic aspiration. To do or get something is also listed as basic aspiration. So what is your basic aspiration? To become an engineer is your basic aspiration, or to get some money out of it, to get some name and fame out of it, your basic aspiration, or to be happy and prosperous is your basic aspiration. Can you respond in the chat box? And the present effort of your studying, okay, toiling hard, doing internship, is this your basic aspiration? What is your basic aspiration? So this clarity has to be there. See, you are going to mentor the students. You are going to run the induction program. So you have to be clear about that. I could see that most of the responses are saying that the basic aspiration is the present effort. It means you have not been able to follow this, not been able to understand this. Yeah, let me take some response. Dr. Abhijit?
Yes, sir. Am I audible?
Audible, sir. Yes.
Basically, your aspiration to become an engineer, to do, become something, that is what I responded. That in life, one has to reach to certain position, then only people will listen to you. With that particular intention, my reply was to be something. Not the efforts, because efforts are there to do something in life, actually.
When you are saying about reaching some position in your life, that is also to get something, not to be something. Yes. That is something that we have to be clear.
Yes.
So but the basic
aspiration is something which you would like to get. That is what my understanding is, aspiration. Is to become something in your life. Like somebody would say that I would like to become a faculty.
That's what we are asking, sir. Is that your basic aspiration or something else is your basic aspiration?
The basic is always to become happy. Like what
that's true. Huh? This is what we are trying to focus upon.
We have to remain happy.
Yes.
As per our Indian philosophy, we would always like to become happy.
No, let us not go by some other kind of thing. Let us look into our own natural acceptance and try to see.
Yes.
Whatever we are doing.
Basically, we have to remain happy and prosperous. That is always there. It is absolutely right.
Okay. Nice. So which one is your basic aspiration? This is something that we have to address. So this is the basic aspiration, to be happy and prosperous. If it is not clear, then you can ask your question in the chat box also. So what we are trying to convey here and trying to explore also, that the basic aspiration is to be happy and prosperous. And the next thing to see is that if I'm clear about this, then I will have the right path to fulfill this basic aspiration. Because if you look at the present effort, let's say somebody is studying hard, okay? Now, whether by studying hard, the person is going to become a doctor or engineer or not is questionable. One may not qualify NEET, or one may not qualify GATE, or one may not qualify JEE, and then one may not be able to become an engineer. So that is questionable. Now, even if somebody gets admission into some kind of program, okay, whether one will be able to get a good job or not is questionable. Whether one will be able to do some good research is questionable. Whether one will be able to make one's parents proud is questionable. So there is another question mark here. And by doing all this, whether you are going to be happy or not, it remains questionable for a long time. Okay, we can see that people who have been able to get to some high position or able to become billionaire, they are not able to say for sure that they are leading a happy life. So that remains a question. So what would be the right way to go? Is it from left to right or right to left? Can you respond in the chat box? What would be the right way to proceed? To go from left to right or right to left? You can respond in the chat box. Nice. I'm getting most of the responses saying right to left. Some responses saying left to right. Think over it. You see, when you move from left to right, at every step, there's a question mark. And that's why we can see there are so many offenses taking place in the education. Students are committing suicide. Okay. There's so much of turmoil in the education. If we are able to make clear to every student what happiness is, what prosperity is, and this is your basic aspiration, then with that clarity, the student can make out to be happy and prosperous, what does one has to do or get? Okay. And then with that, one can make out what one has to become. And then one can make out what one has to do as a present effort. So if you look at the right way to proceed, it will be like this. If in the family itself, the parents are having the right understanding and they are able to make it clear to the children that see, your basic aspiration in life is to be happy and prosperous, and that also in continuity. So for that, you need to do or get this. And for that, you need to become this. And for that, this is the effort that you have to make. Then the child will have a definite conduct, a definite path, a definite program to proceed. Otherwise, it is just like moving helter-skelter, doing something today, doing something tomorrow, okay? Many times students come to IITs to become an engineer, and then they feel that this does not suit them, and then try to become a manager. So they will go for MBA. And after doing MBA, they will think that again, they are not feeling satisfied. So they will try to become some IAS officer or some, and go into some administrative job. There also, they may not feel happy, and then they move to something else. And this kind of zigzag keeps on taking place. So in place of that, if you are able to make clear to every student that the basic aspiration is to be happy and prosperous, and then this is the program emerging out of it, then the student will have a definite program in life, okay, without any confusion, without any contradiction, without any conflict. Is that true or not? What do you feel? You can write here true or false. What I am saying, does it appeal to you? Is it true? Think about this. This is a very important issue. In fact, if we can look into our own lives in retrospect, we can see that had this been clear to us 30 years back, 40 years back, our path would have been something else, might be. We might not have to go through so much of pain in our life. We might not have to go through so much of struggle in our life. If at the very outset, I had been clear that, see, ultimately, I want to be happy and prosperous. So for that, do I really need to become like this, or something else can also do? Maybe becoming an engineer was not my requirement. Becoming a farmer would have been enough, or becoming kind of associate in my parents' job would have been, you know, something that would have been more appropriate. This is for your self-reflection also. When you're talking to the students, you have to reflect upon yourself also. And that will give you more clarity. Dr. Jasmine wants to say something. Yeah, Dr. Jasmine.
Yeah, good morning, sir. This is Dr. Jasmine from RV College of Engineering, Bangalore. Sir, I have one opinion in this regard. See, I have also voted for present effort, keeping in mind that everyday effort we are putting to have more knowledge towards how to be happy and prosperous. So keeping in mind that, I think some people must have put present effort. It need not be in the terms of the career opted or the work efforts they are doing. It also can keep in mind the efforts we are putting to reach into the destination, that is our expect to be happy and prosperous. And one more thing, one more comment what I want to add, it is, you told the students are, if they are comfortable or clear about their career or aspirations, then there may not be a possibility of switching over from one course to another. But in this regard, one concern I am feeling now, the new educational policies giving a privilege for the students for that. Even there are multiple exit and entry options. So in this context, I need your answer.
Yes, ma'am. So the first thing, let me clarify again. So you also mentioned it. So the basic aspiration is to be happy and prosperous. And for that only you might be making some effort at this moment. Okay, I think this is clear to you. Now, the provision that has been made in the new education policy, if you see, so there also, it is based on the observation that has been made in the current state of society. Okay, so if we are able to clarify this very issue since childhood, since primary education, so that kind of switching will be less. Otherwise, it will continue. Okay, but if somebody is not clear and wants to switch, so that provision has to be made. That is all that the new education policy says. If I'm clear from very childhood that essentially I want to be happy and prosperous, and for that my basic program is to understand harmony and live in harmony, okay, my program in life would be very definite without any confusion, contradiction, conflict, struggle, isn't it?
Sir, that is very much true from, if you are considering the school education we are going to consider from the coming years, but those are already reached in the UG and PG level. I think what will be the conditions, sir?
Yeah, so that can be minimized now. So when they are entering into the bachelor's program also, if they have this kind of clarity, at least the confusion that they have been carrying inside for a long time will get resolved. And sooner or later, this has to go to primary and secondary education. And as we have already mentioned that we need teachers for primary and secondary education. We need parents who will send their children to such educational program. We need policymakers who will promote such programs. And for that, we need to work in higher education.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Yeah, nice, ma'am. So these are the steps towards our basic aspiration, and the right way is to move from 4 to 1. This is what is being proposed, but again, you can keep on exploring it, keep on thinking over it. In fact, if today you can invest your time thinking about your own life, that had you been clear about your basic aspiration since beginning, then what would have been your path of life? Okay, so that will give you a clearer vision about the life ahead. And find out if you take any steps for being unhappy or deprived, you know. So let me take another reflection here. So do you take any steps for being unhappy? Think over it. Do you take any steps of being unhappy? In the meantime, let me take a question for somebody who has not been addressed so far. Mrs. Sushma.
Hello.
Yes, hello.
Ma'am. Hello, sir. Sir, my question was, you are discussing about the topic of happiness and prosperity. My question is, prosperous, do you mean in terms of money, sir? Prosperity in terms of physical? Because in the first reflections, we were thinking about physical accumulation of wealth. So does it actually mean prosperity means in such way?
We had defined prosperity, ma'am. I hope you remember the definition that we have shared in the introductory workshop.
Yes, sir.
So,
yes.
Let me just recap it briefly and we'll talk about it in detail also. So prosperity is the feeling of having more than required physical facilities.
Okay, sir. Sir, my doubt is, suppose if I am a very good artist, say I'm a very good painter, and my passion is towards to take my profession or passion ahead, but sometimes it may not be very rewarding. Sometimes based on my parents' opinion, they might feel that this is not very, you know, your job or career in that field might not be very rewarding or satisfying. So sometimes we are generally, I can see my students have a lot of passion towards learning instruments or, you know, painting, but they are, in terms, they are forced, they are biased, I can say, based on the opinions of their relatives, of their peers, of their seniors. They said, don't take up this branch. You don't have any future. So yeah, since we are trying to inculcate this UHP program for students, in what way can we motivate them so that they can stick on to their, you know, aspirations or aims?
Yeah, there again, I say that this passion, okay, has to begin investigated. What is the source behind this passion? So it could be some kind of preconditioning, it could be some kind of sensation, or it could also come from natural acceptance. So that is something that to be explored, that is to be explored, first thing. So maybe the student has listened to some singer and got passionate about becoming a singer without ever out whether by being a singer, the basic aspiration of continuity of happiness and prosperity is going to be fulfilled or not.
Okay.
So one has to look into the passion also. This passion, is it coming out of some preconditioning or sensation? If yes, then after pursuing that passion also, the life is not going to be happy and prosperous with definiteness. Okay. So this is something that we have to keep open. So students at that stage of life get influenced by so many things. Let's say somebody won a gold medal in the Olympics and they suddenly change their track of imagination that they have to enter into that particular sports. And next time they see something else and they start pursuing.
Fluctuating. Their mind is fluctuating. Sir.
So that's why this kind of exploration is required among the students.
Okay. Thank you.
Nice, ma'am. So let me share the result of the sharing here. Okay. So I think we have to be a little more particular in responding to these questions. 149 people are saying that you take steps for being unhappy. So let me see some hands who are saying that they want to be unhappy. I would like to listen from them. Who wants to be unhappy here? 149 people are saying that they want to be unhappy. Is there somebody here who wants to be unhappy? Please raise your hand. Okay, Mrs. Binita.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning,
actually, in our life or in our day-to-day life or whatever you can tell, there are some situations, we come across some situations where even though we don't want to get into that, maybe there is a situation, there's a solution for it. We don't want to go into that solution, but forcibly we have to do that. We know that we will become unhappy by doing this, but we have to adjust ourselves to that situation. So in those situations, we knowingly we are getting into an unhappy situation. It means we are basically adjusting ourselves.
Okay. This is what you are saying. Okay. So when we ask, do you take any steps for being happy? So you are saying that I want to become happy, but out of the circumstances, I have to take steps which make me unhappy. You are saying this?
Yes, sir.
Okay. If this is what you mean, then fine. Then I think you are looking at it in a different sense. Nice, ma'am. Okay, Dr. Prabhagaran. Dr. Prabhagaran.
Yes, sir. Am I audible to you, sir?
Yes, sir, audible.
See, it is not that I want to be unhappy, never. But I want to take steps for being unhappy. That's what I understood. So whether it is right or wrong, I don't know.
You want to take steps or you are forced to take steps? What you are saying?
No, I want to take steps for the status of being unhappy.
What does that
to mean? Overcome the unhappiness to happiness. For example, if I am not performing in my job and I am getting the remark from our higher ups, so I understand that I am unhappy. So now I want to take steps for being unhappy to become happy. That's what I understood from the reflection and I answered like, okay.
That is not the case. So you are not taking steps of being unhappy. You are unhappy and you are taking steps to come out of that situation.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Exactly. Exactly. Sir, having given the mic, one more doubt I wanted to ask you. In the home assignments, in the home assignments, we have to ask the students for writing down their aspirations, achievements, and concerns. So in that, can you not add the time frame? Or is it not required?
No. So they have to respond by the end of the day. So they have to...
Not that. They have to respond immediately. That's okay. I am asking about the aspirations and achievements within before completing this degree or immediately after 4 years or immediate 5 years time. I want to become so and so. So how to interpret time frame?
Yeah, that they can add. So one thing can be there in continuity. So they want to be happy in continuity. That can be one response. Or they can say that within 5 years, you know, I want to become this.
Yeah.
In the next 10 years.
Yeah, to be specific. Yeah.
That is up to the students. Okay. You can open up that channel.
Okay. Yes, sir. Okay. Thank you, sir. Please.
So for the fulfillment of your basic aspiration, is it essential to choose steps that lead to the basic aspiration or not? Think over it and check if you are choosing the steps with clarity, that the steps will definitely lead to happiness and prosperity. So what do you think? Again, there is a reflection for you here. Are you choosing the basic steps with clarity? So one way of responding to this question would be go again back in your life, look in retrospect and try to see whether you are choosing your basic steps with clarity at that stage of life when you were a teenager. Or it was just because of something that had been said by your parents, or you learned from your friends, or you got information through some media. In fact, let me say that the students of today are much more aware. In fact, I do remember that in our time, like JEE, the entrance examination for IITs, we were hardly aware of that examination till class 10. Suddenly we came to know in class 11 that there is some examination which takes you to some institution which is called as IIT. But if you look at the students today, since the secondary level of education, they are very much aware what examinations are to be taken for which kind of programs. So let me take another reflection or question here. Ms. Gurleen.
Yes, sir. Can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Yeah, good morning, sir. Sir, at times, I've experienced that, you know, even during the initial interactions, at times the student is quite clear what he wants in life, but forced upon by the parents, right? So, I mean, their clarity is lacking. So, what to say to such a student? Like they're into engineering and but he wants to maybe, you know, do farming, and he understands the concept of being prosperous and happy but forced there. And I've tried telling them that eventually you're doing this to make your parents happy, so ultimately you'll be happy to see your parents happy. So, you know, I'm trying to take it towards step four, but you know, you can sense that depression and frustration. So how to deal with such a student when you are just interacting during the initial hours? What to say to such a student?
Ma'am, one way to proceed would be we can get in touch with their parents. So if the students are opting for this kind of program under the pressure or influence of their parents, so we can talk to them also and try to see if some solution comes out. If the student is not interested in that kind of program, is coming into the program only out of some pressure, or some influence, then one will not be happy throughout the stay. So in that case, you can talk to the parents, try to counsel them also. And maybe it comes out through discussion that after going through this particular program, one can do farming in a much better way. One can do one's own household business in a much better way. That can also be an outcome. So if you are not able to settle with the students because the students are under influence of pressure of somebody else, then we can talk to them also. That is one possibility.
Right, sir. Thank you, sir.
Yeah. So 85% of people are saying that, yes, I'm choosing the basic steps with clarity. So I requested you to look in to your past life, by the previous this thing experience when you were a teenager entering into the bachelor's program, and then try to see what was going on inside you to find out this particular thing. So life without clarity or basic aspiration, what comes out of it? So if the basic aspiration where you want to reach and stay there is not clear, that is likely that the direction of your effort may keep changing as assumptions change. You may not know if you have arrived or not. And very likely that there will be a mix of satisfaction, dissatisfaction, happiness and unhappiness. So this could be the outcome. So one thing is that if the basic aspiration, that is goal, is not clear, it is vague, like, so one minute, something came. Then it could be something like aiming for the sky, making money, having fun, enjoying the whole life. And I have seen some t-shirts mentioning you get life only once. A movie also came up, Jindagi Na Milegi Dobara. So the students many times are motivated out of such short-sighted thoughts and vision. And then the basic aspiration is never clear. Okay, it is somewhat vague. And then when they try to work for it, and then they get into conflict with the circumstances, with the people around, and then they have so much of grudge, so much of complaint about the other. And if you look at the state of imagination, it is something like this. Aiming for so many things and not being clear of anything. So the state of imagination becomes something like this. So the present effort is here, then the expectation to get or do something is here, and the expectation to become something is here, and nothing is clear. So let me take one more reflection here. So do I agree with this regarding what is being said? Dr. Suresh, you wanted to ask something? Dr. Rachana.
Good morning, good afternoon, sir. Thank you for the opportunity. Can you hear me, sir?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Thank you for the opportunity given, sir. Especially you are told that, sir, few people or students are telling that their life is meant for having enjoyment. Sir?
Yeah. Please tell me what is the question, sir.
You told that people are saying that they earn money and have fun. Life is one time life. But as far as them also, they are saying that their aspiration, expectation is being happiness. But the way they are getting the happiness may be different. How to convince them, sir? Because if you ask, they tell that I want to be happiness by this way, by enjoying the life of each and every moment. How to make them to understand the realities?
So we'll talk about the basic aspiration. Out of that enjoyment, what are you trying to get? And are you trying to get something in continuity or for a limited period of time?
Okay.
So this enjoyment is very short-lived, very temporary.
Okay.
You eat something in a restaurant and the taste is lost the next day.
Okay.
Listen to music and the taste is lost after a few hours, isn't it? So the kind of imagination that they carry within, many times it is driven by sensation. So we can discuss with them that whatever you try to get through sensation is not going to continue.
Okay.
Isn't it?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. So one more thing, sir. You have given the home assignments just five slides back. That is for faculty for us, or that for during the program we have to give it to students, sir?
The assignment is for you, sir. The assignment that is being shared in the workshop is for you.
The home assignment that you have given some 4 to 5 slides back at the end of the session one.
Okay. That is for the students.
Okay, sir.
Yeah, that is for the students. They will come up. So whatever we are displaying here in the slides, this is meant for students. But what you are getting additionally in that
that's Google through form, the link.
Okay. That is for you.
Okay, sir. Okay. And one more thing, sir, that is you are given that efforts. What are the efforts we are doing? Mm-hmm. You are given that first option is aspiration. Second option is confusions and other things. Third one is something else. Mm-hmm. Which are all things comes under something else, sir?
Whatever occurs to you in addition to this?
That's you told that first one is aspiration. Whatever efforts, you're doing some efforts, whether it is because of to achieve the aspirations or do you are doing some efforts for confusions. And the third one is something else.
Something else means we are not trying to restrict that this could be only possibility. If something occurs to somebody, okay, then there has to be some scope of sharing it. That's why you have written something else.
Okay, sir.
Okay. You're not trying to restrict that this could be the only possibility.
Okay.
If there's some other possibility, then you can write it here.
Yeah, sure. Thank you, sir.
Nice, sir. So almost all of you are saying that you are able to relate to this particular thing and you agree with this. So life with clarity of basic aspiration would be something like this. So our basic aspiration, that is human goal, is very clear. The destination is fixed. We know our current state with right evaluation. And then we plan steps that connect and lead to the fulfillment of the basic aspiration. And then the direction is definite. So we can see whether in our life also the direction has been definite or not. Since we entered the bachelor's program, from then, the direction of my life, the direction of the efforts that I have made throughout, has it been definite or has it been somewhat fluctuating? So this kind of fluctuation results when the clarity is not there. If the clarity is there, then we'll have a very kind of smooth journey in life. Okay, so something as kabhi khushi kabhi gham, you know, we written here. So this is our basic aspiration, which is called as nirantar sukh. So I want to be here, essentially. Each one of us essentially aspires to be here, but we might be living here in the current state, and then we may be having very fluctuating kind of thoughts, imagination, aspirations, desires, cravings in us. Okay. So our life is fulfilling when we are able to ensure this, to be always happy and prosperous. So you can see with some exploration, and the student can also see, I have found that the students are mature enough to see this, that their basic aspiration is being happy and prosperous in continuity. Okay. It is something definite. It does not keep changing. Okay. What I have generally observed while working with the students, that they are able to see this, they are able to appreciate this, but because of some deep preconditioning, so some pressure from inside, because they have thought about something for so long, they are not able to evaluate it rightly. They are not able to come out of that kind of internal pressure, and then they try to go for this. But at the same time, they are able to see that this is not going to take them to the coveted state, to the desired state of being happy and prosperous in continuity, isn't it? So thinking, doing something, expecting to become something, expecting to get or do something, right? Ultimately is focused at being happy and prosperous in continuity. This is something that we can share with the students on the very second day when they come for discussing with us. So are there many paths or only one? Now that we can distinguish between basic aspiration and the path to fulfill it, find out what would be the appropriate if your favorite path is closed. Continue to be unhappy about it or find an alternate path. This is one major question that the students have to address. So let me take one reflection from you here. what would be appropriate if your favorite path is closed? Let's say you wanted to go to, some student wanted to go to IIT but could not go, so had to go to triple IIT or NIT. Okay, somebody wanted to go to triple IIT or NIT but could not get admission there and had to go to some private college. So will one feel depressed throughout the life out of that, or try to make an alternate path? Let me take a few questions here. So, Ms. Dipali, Dr. Pralay.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, sir.
Sir, actually, few things are coming in my mind. Actually, it's a little tough going because see what you are discussing. Maybe students are taking admission in a college, maybe after HS and all, say age of 18, and maybe almost at the fag end of their teenage, and happiness, aspirations, and from that the prosperity. It's from individual, and from that individual to society, from the society to larger area, and after all the nation of the country. So but first from the individual, maybe from the students himself or herself. But thing is that maybe graduation level from first year after higher secondary, many things were unattended related to self aspirations or happiness related aspects. If we are considering not only the education related, maybe the other extracurricular or other aspects, maybe sports or cultural aspects or paintings, and maybe many things in school life also, only it's not properly addressed or attended, and the certain aspects that time only finished. And once the student in 10th standard or 11th, 12th standard, maybe it was the arts bound kind of the strength and all, and the from some patients converted into the science background or something not a acceptable kind of results and all, then took advantage and all. Domain wise, if I give you example, say maybe say tourism, or maybe so the student is there in this year, whichever the different other areas in that particular domain, whatever they the student interest as to or to be prospective in that particular area, there we could correlate, we could guide, we could tell them, and accordingly we take them. But rest other is unattended or which was not taken care, because see these all are the programs that the previous, because see first FDP also it was discussed that okay, from school level or the from parents level or from a previous level, considering the overall prosperity or country's prospects altogether or society's prospect. I don't know that only the area, it's a little difficult area. And if earlier stage it could be taken care, the majority of things would be more streamlined. And here this particular college level, UHB, and taking considerations, all these maybe emotional aspects, emotional intelligence, and combining with this UHP things to be the workplace, prosperity, aspirations, all will be in proper shape. But thing is that if it is not nurturing from a little earlier stage, maybe the school age or maybe their 11th, 12th or the higher school age, or the primary level. So many other things or the prospects or the where the person or the students feeling to be happy or certain qualities are there to be prosperous in life in terms of society or country, larger states, which we all are missing. that's a little challenge area. What
yeah, sir,
I feel that.
Let me just say, what is your question essentially?
Questions that different other interest area, which was there with a particular student, maybe academic wise or field wise or certain other areas, so where the students would be more happy if not nurtured earlier, and we are getting it in a advanced stage where those things are exploration possibilities are less, then the ultimate happy kind of aspects, how it could be taken care.
So you are saying that the path that the student wanted to take, if that has not been, or that has been missed out, then how the student can be happy?
Yes. Yes.
Is that what you are saying? Yeah. So essentially, one will have to see whether one has verified also or not that the path that one has thought of.
Yes, sir. Absolutely right.
Yeah. The path that one had thought of going ahead, okay, which one feels that will make one happy and prosperous, is that verified or not? Or it is out of some preconditioning or sensation. So somebody may feel that if one becomes a singer, the life will be happy in eternity. But has one verified this? If one becomes a sports star, then the life will be happy in continuity. Or if somebody becomes a businessman, a business tycoon, the life will be happy in continuity. But has that been explored again? So now two things here. One thing, the student aspired for something and that has been missed out. That path is closed. Okay, so one is unhappy.
Yes.
But has one also verified that the path that one had been aspiring for, the goal that one had been aspiring for, was that taking him to the state of happiness and continuity or not? If that is also not sure, then it's better to reevaluate the whole thing. Isn't it?
That's the alternate path, alternate path also.
Not only but, alternate, I say
for all the possible paths not happened.
I say that for all the possible paths that the student is able to see, one has to verify whether it is taking the state of happiness and continuity or not.
You are true, sir, but it's not reevaluated, not evaluated, not explored, whichever the chosen path in the childhood time and all. That also the kind of lacking what ultimate prosperity and happiness someone is searching. And finally, imposing something in the after 18th, 19th year, or maybe 20th year of age. But thing is that if those kind of these kind of things are nurtured a bit advanced, means earlier stage, so those the possibilities could be there that those aspects also could be evaluated or nurtured. What I mean to say.
Yeah, agreed. But there, as I mentioned earlier also, to take it to primary or secondary education, we need to develop some teachers, parents, you know. So for that, some preparation is required. But ultimately, we have to be there. Yes, that is taken.
Thank you, sir.
Nice, sir. So most of you are saying that you will find an alternate path. That is very good to see. In place of feeling depressed about it, continuing to feel unhappy about it, you try to look for some alternate path. So examples could be, I wanted to go to the US for my degree, but I was forced to take admission here by my parents and my dreams are shattered. I did not get the branch of my choice and my motivation to study is gone. I did not get the institute where I wanted to be and I'm feeling unhappy about. So these could be various concerns of the students. So the home assignment is here after having discussed all this, and the students will have to do this after the session is over. So write your conclusions or takeaways from the exploration in this session. Is your basic aspiration really happiness and prosperity? What is your perspective about happiness? What is your perspective about prosperity? What do you mean by happiness? Even if the student agrees that, yes, I want to be happy, I want to be prosperous. Okay. So what is their vision about happiness and prosperity? Many times the vision is colored by preconditioning and sensation. Okay. They feel that being wealthy and being prosperous is the same thing. Enjoying life through various sensations and being happy is the same thing. So we have to learn from them what they do really think about happiness and prosperity. And then reflect on your response of or reaction to situations where a favorite path to what you assumed to be your goal was closed, and write down one related incident. So this is something that the students will be doing on the second day. So every day we have 1.5 hour session. So after having discussed all this, you will give this assignment to the students. And as we have been interacting in the session right now, in a similar manner, we feel like interacting in the induction program also, allowing every student to speak up, come out with one's own set of thoughts and share with the batchmates. So again, this is written, this is something to be written in the UHE1 notebook. So the students are advised to make one notebook in the very beginning of the induction program and do all these assignments in a single notebook so that they can revisit it. They can look back into it in the second year, in the third year, and try to see what was their state when they entered into the program, and are they able to align, or are they able to at least relate with that particular sharing. Okay, so I'll not take any more questions right now. So let me just go over the key points. So every student has some aspirations, but may not be clear about the basic aspiration. The basic aspiration of every human being is continuity of happiness and prosperity. The right way to proceed is to be clear of the basic aspiration first and then decide the program to fulfill it. At the level of implementation, there can be several ways in terms of becoming something, doing or getting something to fulfill the basic aspiration. And many a times the favorite path chosen by the student might be based on some borrowed notion or sensation, and they need help in exploring all the possibilities. So one fruitful exercise could be when they are able to see that if they want to be happy and prosperous in continuity. So we can then ask the student, so now tell me, what could be your favorite path? Doing engineering is one path. What could be some alternate path? And then you'll see that if they are able to look into alternate paths, so in place of wasting their time out of frustration during academics, they can try to utilize that time in doing something fruitful, doing some creative thing, doing some useful project, learning some courses online. Those could be various channels in which they can utilize their time and energy in place of just reading some book and then appearing for exams and feeling frustrated over the marks that they have got in the examinations. If those alternate paths are also opened up, so by the time they graduate, they will be adept in more than one skill. Engineering would be one skill, okay? But by that time, maybe somebody by oneself has learned to become a UI UX designer, somebody has learned to become an artist, okay? Those possibilities are also there. So this is something that we can explain to the students. So having this